3:30 p.m. I log in to get my next assignment. The client is what I expect, a nameless corporate entity that isn't bothering with fancy letterheads and getting straight to the point. The message on my screen is short and precise. Request: 2 ocular implants, fresh, prefer green. Fee: $1,500 are negotiable upon receipt. I'm online for less than 2 minutes, no more and no less. It's easier to not get traced that way. Closing the connection to the dark web, I gather my equipment and move out to start my job. 4:20 p.m. I think I do a pretty good job at selecting donors. Usually I search for people who don't really deserve the good in their lives, the ones that take it for granted. This one is no different. Homeless, wasting their money on booze and drugs. It's doubtful they'll even miss their eyes once I carve them out of their skull. The screams are hard to hear, but I'm strong enough to ignore it and get what I came for. If they are lucky, I kill them. If not, they will go the rest of their life remembering our encounter. 5:30 p.m. I log back in, sending a message to the client. This time it's my turn to try and be succinct. Punctuality and preciseness are appreciated in this sort of business. This much I have learned quickly. Package sent, requesting payment. Further items can be queued for future delivery. I always make sure to include that last little bit as a means to promote myself, although I have never had the same client twice. But to my surprise, the representative is online and requests a chat. This is unusual. It sends some red flags through my mind, but I know not to ignore it. Whatever they have to tell me, it's obviously important. You've proven to be quite a capable agent. Your finesse and attention to detail are exquisite, the message reads. I appreciate the kind words, sir, I respond. No need for those formalities. Call me Derek, he answers. This is highly informal, I realize. The contacts I usually get business from never get personal with me. It's just the nature of the job. I have a proposal to continue your work with us, Aaron, the message reads. My heart starts to race. Everything about this conversation that had seemed unnatural has immediately heightened 10 times. They know me. Of course they know me. They've been monitoring me since day one. Everything I have done in this hell is to erase my past, but with one simple stroke of the keyboard, they have brought it all back. You must be panicking right now, but there is not a need for alarm. You've proven how capable you can be, so I think you'll see very soon how those skills will be useful to you over the next few hours, the message said. What do you want with me? I asked back in the chat. You've been on the run for as long as you can remember, Aaron. What we are offering to you is a chance to go home, Derek responds as an order pops up on screen. It's a few different types of organs, ranging from grown adult brains to spleens from children and appendages that I figured could be used for all sorts of nefarious purposes. But I recognize immediately that these aren't just random requests anymore. The company is targeting the people from my past. I gritted my teeth, knowing that refusal would be a death sentence. I had to get to them before my time ran out. Understood. Mission accepted. I responded to Derek as I logged off and got the tools I would need for the job. Feet, fingers, ears, heart. I would need to be perfect to protect the people I cared about. 7:30 p.m. 3 years ago, I'd have laughed if you told me that people sell organs on the dark web. It sounded like a fairy tale, some silly little fable to scare children away from doing something that they weren't supposed to. Then, mid-October, I was in a car wreck and headed for surgery. I would need a new heart to survive. I remember lying there and thinking to myself that I would do anything to save my body, but I simply couldn't afford the expense. It's not like there were any fresh hearts just laying around. Plus, the person that I'd been in a car wreck with was a well-known member of the community. I knew that since they also needed the same surgery, it was likely they would get the treatment instead of me. Then a friend of mine that had been visiting me frequently in the hospital watching my body begin to shut down made the odd conversation about the dark web. I know it sounds crazy, Aaron, but people can actually get what you need from the strangest of places, no questions asked. You simply pay them a fee, and the organs will be here by morning, he told me. I told myself it couldn't be that easy, but the prices offered on the dark web were just within my budget. I was that close to tasting a second chance on life. Of course I would take it. I still remember the first request, hooked up to machines in the hospital, making a deal with devils online. Requesting one new heart, will make good on payment once recovered. I told myself I was willing to do anything for another chance. When the next day I discovered the organ was there and I was being prepped for surgery, I found out exactly what the price tag was. Your social media profile shows you are a hunter, Aaron. You know the ins and outs of properly cleaning dead bodies, getting the best parts from a deer or wild hog. Humans aren't any different, the job offer told me. Work for us to pay back the remainder of your debt, and you'll never have to worry about anything again, the message said. These memories flooded back to me as I drove across town to my old stomping grounds. I hadn't been able to successfully keep this new life from hurting the people I still cared about. But tonight, I would make sure their safety was ensured. 9 p.m. I've learned a lot in the years I've worked for clients on the dark web, more than I ever cared to admit. Killing has become second nature for me. So as I stand outside the house where I once had a life and see my ex-girlfriend standing there doing dishes, oblivious to the hit that is looking over her head, I can't help but to feel broken inside. It would only take two simple shots to the head, and she would never feel a thing. Her organs would be taken off in a matter of seconds. I aimed my weapon with a shaking hand, and then I fired. 11 p.m. Later that night, I'm in the hospital again. A different surgery is about to take place. Two hands will be removed for the payment to my clients. I ask them to let me use a computer before the operation begins, and I shoot a message to the ones I'm leaving behind. This isn't the life I wanted or cared for, but I have done everything in my power now to protect you. No one will come for you. No one will hurt you. I promise, Aaron. I know that it won't take long for them to get it once I recover from my injuries. By that time, all that would be left to fulfill the client's request is a heart. 2:30 a.m. At some point, I'm awake after surgery, looking down at the stubs of flesh that were once my hands and feet, both destroyed forever so that the people who have forgotten about me don't have to suffer. This feels like a fitting end to my career as an agent of darkness, that the last organs I supply to the dark web are my own. My clients have learned to trust me. They'll never think twice about using them. Clients like Derek that need these organs will offer them like puppy dogs with wet bones to their suppliers. They'll never question where the organs came from. They never do. 4:30 a.m. My surgery is about to start. I'm told that I have a message in my private laptop. I know it's likely another client checking on their order. But no, this one is different than I expected. It's a reply to my farewell. It pains us to see that you have chosen to take your own life rather than that of others. Such a sacrifice feels like a waste. Don't you recognize that as long as the world turns, there will be people like us and people like you? Your sacrifice is meaningless, the email read. Tears swell up in my eyes, but I can't let them know they have won. I have to be strong for everyone. So I ignore their messages and tell the surgeon I'm ready. It's time to say goodbye. If you are reading this now, it should be 7 a.m. after my untimely death. All of my organs have been harvested and supplied to the ones that asked for them. Those new organs will have already been placed in their hosts, dangerous people, unaware of the fact that I poisoned my own body and laced it with drugs designed to be untraceable even during an organ transplant. They'll be joining me in hell soon enough. I've arranged for this message to spread across the rest of my client list on the dark web as a warning. It's true, there may one day be people just like me who will do anything to extend their lives, but there will also be people who put others first, regardless of the harm to themselves. My prayer is that my journey into the abyss inspires them. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and smash that like button to get notified every time I upload a new video. You can also check out some more of my animated horror stories right here.